Hello students, welcome to Easy Elimu Learning Simplified. My name is Mr. Stanley Ombogo. So dear students, as usual, I believe that you are in good health and strength wherever you're watching us from. So it is another interesting episode or session that we have here. And in this session, I'd like to take you through an area in grammar, and that is participle phrases. Participle phrases. So before we get to look at what participle phrases are, just as a reminder, remember previously in back in Form 3 work, we learned about participles. So some of the things that we learned were, number one, a participle is a type of verbal. And number two, we have three types of participles. That is the present participle, the past participle, and the perfect participle. So just to remind you, of a few details about these three types. We said that the present participle is formed by adding the suffix ing to the base of a verb. So if we have the verb walk, for example, and we add the suffix ing to it, the new verb that will be formed will be walking, and that is now the present participle of the verb walk. So also we said that in past participle, the regular verbs normally end in the suffix ed, while irregular ones end in the suffixes such as en, n, t, or various other endings. So for example, if we have the verb walk and we add the suffix ed, we will form a new form of a verb that is now walked, and we use walked in past participle. So the last type that we also said something about was the perfect participle, and we also learned that the perfect participle is used to shorten or combine clauses that have the same subject. So again, they are used in cases where one action is completed before the next one starts. So immediately, one action is completed, the other one starts. Now, on to what we want to talk about, that is with regards to participle phrases. Number one, a participle with one or more objects or modifiers is what form a participle phrase. So the sentence below illustrates this. In the sentence, we have the first one: the cat eating meat and fish belongs to me. The cat eating meat and fish belongs to me. In the sentence, the underlined phrase is the participle phrase. So a participle phrase with one or more object or modifiers forms a participle phrase. So looking at that sentence, the cat eating meat and fish, we have got two objects. We have got two objects. So the two objects that we have, meat and a fish, again act as modifiers. So that is what forms a participle phrase. So look at the underlined phrase. So the underlined phrase that you see over there is our participle phrase. So the participle in this phrase is eating. So This is a type of a participle that we call the present participle. So remember, we said that the present participle is formed by adding ing. So the participle that we have is eating. The participle that we have is eating. So meat and the fish are our objects, and it is, or they are, what form the participle phrase. So another important thing worth noting, dear students, is that a participle phrase modifies nouns. So to understand these, in the examples below, the participle phrases are underlined while the words modified are in boldface. So keenly study the two examples. So in the first example, we have washed with soap and water, the skirt looked bright. And in the second example, we have the house painted yellow and white appeared new. The house painted yellow and white appeared new. So the underlined are the participle phrases, while the words modified are those that are written in boldface. So another thing now about the functions of participle phrases, dear students. Participle phrases can function as adjectives in sentences. So if they function as adjectives in a sentence, then it means that they give or provide more information or details about the word, the noun or pronoun that they describe. So remember, adjectives are describing words. So apart from that, a participle phrase is also used to combine sentences, that is two or more sentences, or even shorten them. So in the examples below, we have examples of sentences that have been combined or shortened using a participle phrase. So in the first example, we have two sentences. The teacher is in his office, and another sentence is that he sent the secretary to call Jonathan. So if we use a participle phrase to combine the two sentences, we will form a new sentence that now reads, sitting in his office, the principal sent the secretary to call Jonathan. So the next or the second example of a sentence that has been combined or shortened using a participle phrase, we have, I forgot my pen at home, full stop, I borrowed a pen from Ellie. I forgot my pen at home. That is our first sentence. The second one is that I borrowed a pen from Ellie. So we can have that or the two sentences joined using a participle phrase, and by doing that, we will form a new sentence that is, having forgotten my pen at home, I borrowed one from Ellie. Then the third example, the author is being interviewed, full stop, the author is a Caribbean. So the new sentence formed reads, the author being interviewed is a Caribbean. So again, we have another example. Have you read this novel? It was written by Margaret Ogola. So the new sentence formed by, that is combining the two, is, have you read this poem written by Margaret Ogola? So lastly, we have this other example. So I am a vegetarian, I don't eat meat. So our new sentence formed by combining the two is, being a vegetarian, I don't eat meet. So our participle phrase in the last sentence is being a vegetarian. So dear students, that brings us to the end of this session. Thank you for keeping it easy, Elimu, and I look forward to having you in more episodes to come. Until next time, bye.